I think that's working. Good evening, everybody, and a very warm welcome to you to our Thursday evening recital. In the presence of Dippy the dinosaur, God bless him or her, or it, I just draw you to attention things that are happening in September. George is playing, Ashley's playing in October, and then I'm playing again in November. We're still on sort of... Sorry. This is going very well this evening. I hope it's not a sign of things to come. So we're still on sort of our COVID routine with Thursday evening recitals, which we're screening and streaming and doing for the audience. And you're very welcome. It's great to see you. I'm just going to talk about the first two pieces here, and then I shall go upstairs and talk to you from the console. I'm going to start with a resting piece of Alexandre Guillemont. Guillemont was the organist of La Trinité in Paris for 30-odd years, finishing in 1901. He was a great teacher, performer, and improviser. And he founded the academic institution, the Schola Cantorum of Paris. But eventually he was appointed as professor of organ to the Paris Conservatoire, where he succeeded Vidor. And he taught many of the prominent French organists of the 20th century, and particularly Marcel Dupré, which has a symmetry with the last piece by Harold Britton, who was himself taught by Dupré. Guillemont was a great composer of organ music, really. He didn't really compose much for anything else. 8 sonatas and countless other works. And Sonata 5 has 5 movements, but the first movement, I think, is a really good starter for a recital. It's a sort of heroic theme which reoccurs a number of times. It has a fugal section and a lyrical section and ends with a big crash at the end. So I think it's a good one to start a recital. Now, Vivaldi's output, as we know, was huge, and it's difficult to believe that he was also a priest. And it's very sad to believe that he died impoverished after his royal patronage finished, being such a celebrated composer who we love today. And his concerto output was also enormous, and this concerto is actually one of 230 or so violin concertos that he wrote. And Bach, being a real magpie, transcribed it as a keyboard concerto, but it's also been arranged for trumpet and other instruments. It's in the usual 3 movement format, a quick, a slow, and a quick, and it's a really lovely piece of joyful Baroque music. So some Guillemont and Vivaldi to start. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, sadly, Beethoven didn't write anything for the organ, just like Mozart. They just wrote things for mechanical clocks and glass harmonicas. But I thought that the adagio from the Pathetic Sonata actually works really very well on the organ, and you can ring the changes on some of the softer stops. He wrote it when he was 27 years old, this sonata, and it was an instant success and really put him on the map in many ways with his piano music. It owes much to Bach and Mozart in that there's material taken from some of their pieces, a partita and a sonata. The adagio, of course, is so famous it's been used numerous times as incidental music, theme tunes for various radio programs, and I think its gentle, lovely melody works really well on the organ. So here is the slow movement from Beethoven's sonata Pathétique.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now, Judith Bingham is one of our most celebrated women composers and is particularly noted for her choral music, but has written some organ music. She studied at the Royal College of Music, and in 1971 she won the Principal's Prize for Composition and subsequently the BBC Young Composer Award. I won a prize at the Royal Academy of Music, the Croft Original Trophy for Baroque Ensemble. And the prize was a crate of Croft Original Sweet Sherry, which I did polish off in very quick order with some friends. But her prize was infinitely more grand than mine, the composition prize in 1971. Of this piece, she said, "I wanted to write about rebirth. And St. Bride is the Celtic goddess Bridget reborn. And in legend, she visits the Nativity, where time itself is reborn." Now, the piece is in sort of three sections, and people who are here in the cathedral have got the poem associated with it on the right-hand side of their program page. But for anybody who may be listening at home, the three sections, and these words are written in the score at various bits on the music. "A strange sun rising on a barely swelling sea. Clouds veil the sky's mystery. Night rises from his cold, dark bed." And that's the opening, quiet, rather somber section. And then, "assisted by angels and the Spirit of God, the sleeping saint is flown across oceans. As a cloud in a cloudless sky, the birds see her flying." And the music reflects this in a much more upbeat, dazzling way. And then backwards it goes, as it says, "backwards in time to the beginnings of her faith she goes, to the Nativity where God made time anew. A memory of past time, at once sweet and sad, full of longing, regret, forgiveness and love." And it closes with what is sounds like a little Highland lament, really, on the string stops. It's a very beautiful piece. So here is St. Bride assisted by the angels.
Thank you very much. Now I'm going to read you some more poems, which is very unlike me. And I'm going to play a few movements from A Wonderful Animal Parade by Ian Farrington. Now, Ian Farrington was the pianist alongside Rowan Atkinson at the opening ceremony of the London Olympics. If you watch the video again, you'll see somebody playing the piano next to him. He was a previous organ scholar at St. John's College, Cambridge, and he has a very busy career as a pianist, organist, composer, arranger, working in all different styles, done a huge amount of recording, and he has a passion for bringing music to as wide an audience as possible. He's a remarkable chap, Ian, and he wrote this extraordinary piece. In September, George will be playing Sanson's Carnival of the Animals, and this is Ian's sort of alternative to Carnival of the Animals, using a load of animals that certainly Sanson left out. And there are some poems. Now, unfortunately, we have no dinosaur piece, but I think we can imagine what Dippy would have sounded like. So that's the Carnival of the Animals dinosaur, just very briefly for your entertainment. And I shall go on to reading some poems now that were written by Esther Eidenau to go with these little pieces. So here's giraffes. I'll stick my neck out and guess I probably make you laugh. It's okay, you can confess. After all, I am a giraffe. My looks provoke a grin as I teeter through the trees. My legs are, it's true, quite thin, and I do have knobbly knees. But please keep your laughter in check. I have something of a surprise. No, I don't mean my long neck, but my great big beautiful eyes. Oh, isn't that sweet? So that's the giraffe. Now, in the Sanson Carnival of the Animals, of course, there is the very beautiful aquarium. But this is not an aquarium that you'd like to go into with the piranhas. So still, so quiet, as still as death. If we weren't fish, we'd hold our breath. So still, so quiet, so still we wait to seal some foolish creature's fate. Then we spy lunch, and up we bunch, and all you hear is munch, munch, munch. So there's this rather tense atmosphere, and then the organ crashes in with various feasts, and you'll hear them snapping from time to time as well. So that's piranhas. Penguins are a little bit more friendly, as you can imagine. And this is what the poet wrote about the penguins. So off we go, mile after mile, across the snow in single file. To keep us warm against the gales, our uniforms, white tie and tails. We've also hired bright yellow wellies and all acquired white ample bellies. And when we tire and start to feel our feet on fire, our blisters peel, rather than stop or take a ride, we belly flop and slide, slide, slide. So that's the penguins. And then finally, the barrel organ monkey, which is a completely crazy piece. When the music begins, I'll start to dance. Put a penny in the cup, please give me a chance. In my tiny suit with its matching cap, I can make you smile, even make you clap. But while I dance and stand on my hands, I am remembering distant lands. And when the organ ceases to play, for a few moments more, I am far away. So here are four movements from Ian Farrington's Wonderful Animal Parade.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, and apologies to those who thought they were coming to a serious organ recital this evening. From the ridiculous to the sublime, I thought I'd put in some very beautiful Vidor between the Farrington and the Harold Britten when we go crazy with Gershwin. Vidor, of course, was an organist of Saint-Sulpice, the largest church organ in France, for well over six decades. And there's actually a recording of him playing his toccata, of course, and there's also a recording of him playing this very piece on that organ, which is wonderful to hear. It's a very lovely, tender melody, opening on the flutes and then into a middle section and coming back. It's a really still, beautiful piece, and I thought it would go well to just calm us all down before the final piece in the program. So here's Vidor, the Andante Sostenuto, from his Gothic Symphony. Thank you very much. And finally, to the Variations on I Got Rhythm by Harold Britton. Gershwin, of course, needs no introduction. He wrote this for Girl Crazy in the 1930s, and it's, of course, become one of his most famous songs. We all know the tune, I think. Now, Harold Britton was civic organist at the Town Hall in Walsall for over 40 years, and he was one of the great Town Hall organists of his generation. He was taught by Dupré, who himself was taught by Gilmour at the start of the recital, and he stunned people with his entertaining programs and wonderful playing, both here and abroad. And he put together this wonderful set of variations, which, of course, being an organ piece, has a short fugue in it, and a pedal solo, which I have a few ankle difficulties with these days. It involves you playing three notes at once, and there's one bit where I simply can't twist my right ankle far enough these days, unfortunately, so I do cheat and put one note on with my fingers, but I hope you won't notice that. And then he plays homage to Dupré towards the end with a toccata-like moment and then a big theatrical finish. It's a wonderful set of variations. So here is I Got Rhythm, arranged Harold Britton.